Hello, I hope this vlog finds you doing well today in Hogsmeade. So we have been celebrating Sukkot, or what you may call Feast of Tabernacles. And this is about a week long holiday. And so why do we celebrate this holiday? Well, if you do some research, you are gonna find all kinds of rich information, but I am gonna show you the messianic reason of why we celebrate this holiday. One of the quotes that I read says, "The Feast of Sukkot is living in a temporary dwelling to remind us that we will dwell with Yeshua one day. And hey, plus, it's pretty fun." And what's funny about that is that growing up, my kids always called this the tent holiday, because we know that the children of Israel, they used to build a tent or a sukkah, and they would eat and celebrate inside of that. And so Jewish people all over the world still do that today, and many of us who have crossed over as a Hebrew and are still walking in the way, we still do that, not because we have to, but like I said, because it's pretty fun. So there's this woman that teaches about walking in the way, or looking at the Bible through the lens of the one new man. And she wrote something really cool that I want to share with you. And if you want to find her on Instagram, she goes by Pursuing Emmett. And she had a picture of a manger, and she said, "Yeshua's birth, he is the reason for the season." And I'm going to continue on with reading what she shared, but many Bible scholars believe that this holiday, or this appointed time, was fulfilled through the birth of Yeshua, and that he actually came to dwell with us as a human during this time of the year. It says, the Bible does not specifically say the date of Yeshua's birth. We know it was not during the winter months because the sheep were in the pasture, and we get that from Luke chapter 2, verse 8. A study of the time of conception of John the Baptist reveals he was conceived about Sivan 30, the 11th week. When Zechariah was ministering in the temple, he received an announcement from God of a coming son. The eighth course of Abib, when Zechariah was ministering, was the week of Sivan 12 to 18. Adding 40 weeks for a normal pregnancy reveals that John the Baptist was born on or about Passover, Nisan 14. We know 6 months after John's conception, Mary conceived Yeshua, and we get that from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 33. So I'm not reading this to make a plug against Christmas. I'm reading this because we have these holidays instituted in the First Testament that we see honored in the Second Testament. And those of us who study the Bible are researching the fulfillment of these holidays. So clearly there is an important parallel here for us still today. Therefore, Yeshua would have been conceived 6 months later in the month of Kislev. Kislev 25 is Hanukkah. Was the light of the world conceived on the Festival of Lights? And I tend to lean towards yes. This is huge. What a beautiful connection. Starting at Hanukkah, which begins on Kislev 25 and continue for 8 days and counting through the 9 months of Mary's pregnancy, one arrives at the approximate time of birth of Yeshua at the Festival of the Tabernacles, or Sukkot. What an amazing time to rejoice. During the Feast of Tabernacles, God required all males to come to Jerusalem. The many pilgrims coming to Jerusalem for the festivals would spill over to the surrounding towns. Bethlehem is about 5 miles from Jerusalem. Joseph and Mary were unable to find a room at the inn because of the influx of so many pilgrims. They may have been giving shelter in a sukkah, which is built during a 7-day period each year accompanying the celebration of the Feast of Tabernacles. Due to the difficulties during travel, it was common for the officials to declare tax time during a temple feast, and we get that from Luke chapter 2, verse 1. We know our Messiah was made manifest into a temporary body when he came to earth. It is possible he also put into a temporary dwelling himself? Highly so. The fields would have been filled with sukkahs during the harvest time to temporary shelter animals. Oh yeah, and the Hebrew word stable is called a sukkot. Genesis chapter 33, verse 17. Pretty amazing. No coincidences. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in a swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And we get this from Luke chapter 2, verse 7. Joseph and Mary took the child and flew to Egypt and remained there until they were told by God that Herod was dead. Joseph and Mary brought the baby Yeshua into Jerusalem 40 days from his birth for Mary's purification and the child's dedication. According to Torah, this had to be done within 40 days of the birth of the male child. Not doing so is considered a sin. This incites that Herod died within the same 40 days because as long as Herod was alive, they could not appear at the temple. According to Joseph's calculations, Herod's death occurred during the autumn in the fourth year before the Common Era. Later in life, Yeshua may have been celebrating his birthday on a mountain with three of his disciples. In contrast to birthday parties such as Herod's, where people were killed for entertainment, he was a celebration of life. On the festival of Sukkot, Moses and Elijah from centuries past, representatives of the Torah and the prophets appeared and talked with Yeshua. One disciple, Peter, suggested building three sukkahs for Yeshua, Moses, and Elijah because it was required for the festival, but he did not understand that these three were fulfilled, that which the festival symbolized. They were dwelling in their sukkot, temporary tabernacles of flesh, awaiting their eternal resurrected temples. Today, a number of believers are celebrating Yeshua's birth during the Feast of Tabernacles, complete with decorations and lights on the sukkah and music. There is so much that I could share on this, but I would really encourage you to find a way to make this time fun. It is a celebration. Party, have feasts, and just really enjoy people. And also take this time to do some Torah reading and really dig deep and reflect on what is this time about and what is the creator of the universe illuminating on scripture and what is he trying to show me and express to me during this time. So love your God, love your family, love your community, and enjoy this time. And I will talk to you again soon. Bye.